Hi, we just got here at Elkhart Lake, Road America in Wisconsin. I'm gonna tell you a story about racing. And all the stories don't happen on the racetrack. This one, however, started there. One of our Porsche IMSA GT3 Cup Challenge drivers, Bryce Miller, he won the last two races. Early in the session, had a little incident. Damaged three of the four corners of his Porsche GT3 car. And here's where the story starts. It's not about driver, it's not about car. We're gonna watch via time lapse the team go to work and support his driver in this program by time-lapsing, putting this car back together to get him ready for qualifying and the next two races of the weekend. Like I said, all the action doesn't always happen on the track. Watch this team go to work. Hunter Wright, you're the team engineer for both cars here in the Effort Racing, Michael Mills and Bryce Miller's car, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, so I don't want to take a lot of your time because you're in the midst of rebuilding this car here. Yeah. What's the big challenge going on as they're raising this motor into the car? What do they have to align? What's so sensitive?
Right now, as they're aligning the motor and the transmission assembly, it's both together. And so really the motor is held in by an engine plate, which is really only two bolts. And then the front of the transmission is held up by about four bolts. So those bolts are obviously very precise about where they go and everything's very, very rigid. So getting it all perfectly lined up to the chassis is the tricky part. You gotta make sure that it's all right where you need it to be because it's all so rigid that there's really no room for flex.
And then once it's in, it's plugged in and you can start putting in the half shafts and that cross member underneath and
Yep, exactly. Stuff like we tie in the bottom of the subframe once we get it in there and then basically it's plugging all the hoses and wires and all that stuff back up to it.
So not to bust his chops, but Bryce left you a lot of work here because front, back of the car. So what does the crew have to do here? It looks like a lot of teamwork, but a lot of pieces here.
There's definitely a lot of teamwork that comes into play in situations like this, and we each all have our strengths and our weaknesses, and in a moment like this, we really prey on some of the guys that have the strength in the front end of the car. Some guys are better with the motor, some guys are better with the suspension, and so we really try to play off of all that and get everybody working as efficiently as possible. That's one of the things is when we come to a situation like this, it's try to be as efficient as you can with everything you're doing.
How do you do that? I mean, do you in effect practice for things like that, or you know who's responsible for what and then it's go time, or how does it happen?
A lot of it is, you'd like to say that you practice it, but a lot of it is, this is practice. This is we're kind of figuring it out as we go right here, and so it's a little difficult, but we also have done a lot of this. It's just not all that you do it always all at once. You'll do one corner or one radiator, but now it's all three radiators, it's all four corners, you know, and so all of it just happens a little bit quicker and you're doing it all at once.
And it sounds like there's a lot of chatting back and forth. I mean, you guys really are working as a team here to pull this together.
Yeah, it's definitely a team effort. It takes everybody. When something like this happens, it takes everybody to join together and really pull for the common goal to get this thing to be able to be successful when we put it back out there.
First time it's back on track is what, 11 something tomorrow?
Right, 11:15 for qualifying.
And once you put all the parts in, we're not done. Then what happens?
Right, after we put everything back together so it's mechanically sound, we'll go back through the setup. We're definitely gonna nail down the setup, make sure we get it about as close as we can with the little bit of track time that we had. And then we're gonna go through a whole list of checks and procedures. We'll run it, we'll test all the gears and do as much as we can before it hits the track so that hopefully when it gets on track everything is 100% ready to go.
So I'm assuming after Bryce has done the apology to the team for putting you to work, he's supposed to clear his mind and just go back to work and
do his
job.
Right, exactly. That's one of the deals. This is where that short-term driver memory comes in very, very handy because that's part of it. I mean, and it's just one of those things. This is part of the industry. It's a very tough part to get your head around when you haven't been around it. But things happen and you have to be able to forget it and overcome. And that's his job, is to get 100% focused on the task at hand. And right now his task at hand is to go out there and qualify the car and then put us in a good position for the race.
And your team is professionals to forgive stuff like this?
Exactly. This is part of our job. This is why we're here, is so stuff like this. When things are going fine, it's not a hard job. Anybody can do it. So when things go wrong, that's when we really get to earn our chops.
Sell it short, Bryce's accident was pretty big. This is a hell of a way to count the parts that make up a Porsche GT3 race car, but got a lot of stuff going on here. Knocked out an eye, the bumper, and here's the back of the car. The wing's really just made of foam. Insulation from the engine, more bodywork, more parts, suspension. No one should be asking the Porsche guy what the bill on this stuff is, but a lot of carnage for really one accident. On the setup pad here at Effort Racing, because there are two other parts to this story reassembling the car for Bryce Miller. It's one of teamwork. In the neighborhood is the other competitive team, Kelly Moss, and they took the tub back to their shop and put it on the frame straightening jig to get the frame true and straight so they could build a good race car. Then that frame got reassembled by Effort Racing and put on their setup pad. what they found is Kelly Moss's work was really, really good. The car is very, very, very true, and the setup is very precise. So Bryce is going to have a good race car. Teamwork. Setup worked, and the bottom line, it's the morning after. We weren't here all night to watch the hard work. Half the crew stayed here all night to get it done. But the bottom line, got a race car ready to go. Bryce has a car he can qualify, and is back to racing.